everybody here, we are about to ordain our sister, Deaconess Emilia. But before I ordain her, this morning I was praying about something. And not too long ago, I told you guys here that every human being, if God causes me to be born by my father here, there is something in him at this age he might not be able to do. But his son, who is 18 years, 25 years or 30 years, when he is older, the things he will not be able to do according to his body, God transfers it to his next generation. Even if the next generation for some reason fails, God will use then the second, the third generation to fulfill the purpose of God. Whether you are born by a poor person, whether you are born by an educated person, whether you are coming from a very dirty family, God has a purpose and a plan for every human being that is alive. Say amen to that. No matter how your status is now, no matter how your life is now, I want you to understand, wherever you are, so long as you are alive, there is an assigned purpose of God for your life. While I was praying before I ordained her, there is something that God placed in her family years ago. She came close to fulfilling it. Please listen, I'm preaching to you, but I'm using Emilia to preach you. She came close to fulfilling the purpose of God in her life. So she married a pastor. How many of you know Deaconess Emilia used to be married to a pastor? So this is an information for you. She married a pastor. But somewhere, somehow, her destiny was supposed to be fulfilled through that channel. So if you read Jeremiah 18, God sent the prophet Jeremiah to go to the house of a potter. A potter is somebody who uses clay to form things. And you know, human beings, we are formed by clay. You know why? Clay, when it's in its raw form, it's flexible. You can use it to do anything. You can use it to form a ball. You can use it to form a pot. You can use it to form a cup. Anything you want to do, you can do with a clay. God sent the prophet Jeremiah in Jeremiah 18 to go to the house of a potter. But the prophet said when he got to the house, the clay man, the potter, was doing some pot. He was trying to form something in a circle. But somewhere, somehow, there was too much water on the clay. So the plant he wants to use, for because the clay was too watery, he couldn't use it because it is too much water. The prophet said he saw the potter now form the clay into something else, which he couldn't use at first to do because there was too much water in the clay. But somewhere, somehow, he used the clay to form something else. If God plans to make you rich, if God plans to make you a runner, if God plans ever purpose to do something with you, and somewhere, somehow, the devil comes into your life to tumble you, to cause you to fall. So long as God has an agenda to be fulfilled in your life, he will find another way, somewhere, somehow, for his purpose to be fulfilled in your life. Lift up your hand and say, God, do something with me.
God, do something with me.
Tell somebody, God, do something with me.
God, do something with me.
Oh, come on, say, God, do something with me.
God, do something with me.
You are the master.
You are the master.
I am a clay.
I am a clay.
Form me into something.
Form me into something.
Use me for something.
Use me for something.
Turn me into something.
Turn me into something.
Let your will be done in my life.
Let your will be done in my
Let
life.
Your purpose be fulfilled in my life.
Let your purpose be fulfilled
in Use me for something.
Use me for something.
Turn me into something.
Turn me into something.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Say amen.
Amen.
So listen, in life, don't ever use your position to look down upon anybody. You might be very rich today and there's somebody who is sitting at the door very poor. But because that person is serving God, Job said, Job 14 verse 7, 8, he said, even the tree that has been chopped in half, it has a what? A hook. So you can be high here today. Bless God for where you are. But while you are there, never look down upon the people. Because tomorrow by this time, this God that is able to turn a clay into something else, God can turn the destiny and the purpose of the person around. And tomorrow by this time, you will be down and the person will be up. Say, God, use me for something.
God, use me.
Say, Lord Jesus, use me for something.
Lord, use me for something.
You are the master.
I am a clay.
Use me for something.
Bless my life.
Turn me around.
Turn me around.
Turn me around.
And cause me to be blessed.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Before I ordained her, while I was praying for her, you know that Jacob, one of the persons that was blessed and blessed and blessed by God was Jacob. He inherited a covenant that God placed on his grandfather. Are you listening? Jacob. And apart from the covenant he inherited from his grandfather, his life was very blessed. But in fact, Jacob was one of the people who really suffered in his life. You know why he suffered? Because he stole from his brother. God wants to bless you. Don't kill me to come and take what I have because you want to be me. God will kill you. Otherwise, God will destroy you. If you are a true Christian, you always wait on the Lord. The Bible said the footsteps of a righteous person is ordered by the Lord. Jacob wanted to become his brother because Jacob felt that God made a mistake and made his brother first and made him second. He stole from his brother. And I was telling somebody that this world, listen, no matter how a bishop, a pastor, a good person you are, if you give anybody a cause, you hurt anybody, you cause anybody to suffer pain in his sight, and he cries unto God, no matter how anointed you are, his cry will reach God and God will destroy you. Jacob stole from his brother. The Bible says his brother cried. The man wept. He wept bitterly, begging his father, that Lord, if there is any little blessing, just give it to me, I'll go. His father, instead of blessing the senior person, Esau, his father cursed him and said, you will serve your younger brother. If it was you, will you be happy? He cried. And such a cry, such a painful cry, it reaches heaven. So you know what God did? Even though God blessed Jacob, he was blessed and blessed and blessed, but that man suffered like something. So even though the blessing was upon him, the blessing cannot be fulfilled on him. Somehow God told David, that David, because your hands are dirty, you cannot build a house for me. Your son must do that. So that even though Jacob was blessed, Jacob cannot inherit the blessing that has been given to him. Somehow his seed, his son, somebody from his loins must come and inherit the blessing. That is why Jacob could not form the Israel, but his son Joseph went into Egypt to become what has been pronounced upon his father. Say amen to that. If God ever purposed to do something with you, and for some reason the enemy comes and chains you and holds you down, once God has fingered his hand towards your house, nothing can take his hand from your house. Whether you are making it or your son will make it. Whether you are breaking through or your son will break through. Whether you have been blessed. And tonight I pronounce the blessings of God upon your house. I pronounce the blessings of God upon your house. I pronounce the blessings of God upon your house. I pronounce the blessings of God upon your house. Lift up your hands and say, raise. Turn the Bible to Genesis 11. I just want to give them a little bit of revelation and we will anoint our sister. All the pastors will join me and we'll do that. Everybody hears about the covenant God established with Abraham. But I'm about to show you the deal did not start with Abraham, but it started with the father of Abraham. Genesis 11, I believe it's 21 or 26 or something. I'm not sure, 26. Everybody read it. And some of you are here. You think you are too old. But that son you have neglected. That son you have ignored. That daughter you don't have any hope in. I'm telling you, God is about to use that same son. God is about to use that same daughter to turn your destiny around. To turn your life around. To turn your home around. To turn your home around. To turn your home around. Lift up your hands and God. Ray. One thing I have come long to know about God, that it's never too late for God to do something with what he has purposed to do. It is never, ever, ever too late. And those of you who are sitting here
And people have taken calculators and tape measurements. Tape measurements, and they are measuring you. They sit in their home, but they know every size. They know you gain about 10 pounds, right? But they know your waist size already. Even though they have never put a tape measure on you, they seem to know everything about you. I just want to advise that enemy of yours that God is about to shame them. I said, I just want to announce to you that your enemy is about to be shamed, because God is about to turn your destiny around. God is about to turn your future 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 around. Lift up your hand one more time and God, rest.
Genesis 11 verse 26.
The book of Genesis chapter 11, the verse number 26.
Yes.
After Terah had lived 70 years.
What is the name?
Terah.
You know that is the father of Abraham. Go ahead.
After Terah had lived 70 years,
mm-hmm.
he became the father of Abraham,
mm-hmm.
Nahor, and Haran.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 27.
Mm-hmm.
This is the account of Terah's family line.
Go ahead.
Terah became the father of Abraham,
mm-hmm.
Nahor, and Haran.
Mm-hmm.
And Haran became the father of Lot.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 28.
Mm-hmm.
While his father Terah was still alive,
mm-hmm.
Haran died in Ur,
mm-hmm.
of the Chaldeans,
mm-hmm.
in the land of his birth.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 29. Abraham and Nahor,
mm-hmm.
both married.
Mm-hmm.
The name of Abraham's wife was Sarai,
mm-hmm.
and the name of Nahor's wife was Milcah.
Mm-hmm.
She was the daughter of Haran,
mm-hmm.
the father of both Milcah and Iscah.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 30.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Sarai was childless,
mm-hmm.
because she was not able to conceive.
Mm-hmm.
31. Terah took his son Abram, his grandson Lot, son of Haran, and his daughter-in-law Sarai, the wife of his son Abram, and together they set out from Ur of the Chaldeans to go to Canaan.
To go to where?
Canaan.
To go to where?
Canaan.
Everybody say Canaan.
Canaan.
Say, I want to get to my Canaan.
I want to get to my Canaan.
Oh, come on, professor. I want to get to my Canaan.
I want to get to my Canaan.
Listen to me. This is the father of Abraham, 70 years old man. He gathered his family somewhere somehow. He didn't have a wife. Maybe the wife died. They didn't mention the name of his wife. But the first purpose of his life when he gathered his family was to where? Go to where? Go to where?
Canaan.
Go to where?
Canaan.
So they set out to go to Canaan. What happened on the way?
Verse 32. But Terah lived 205 years, mm-hmm. and he died in Haran.
Mm-hmm.
Chapter 12.
No, you didn't finish what you're reading. Read on, please. You jump too much. There is a one word I want to preach on it. That is Emilia. It's going to be your word. Okay? Hear me, everybody. Go ahead.
Verse 31.
Yeah.
Terah took his son Abram,
mm-hmm.
his grandson Lot,
mm-hmm.
son of Haran,
yeah.
and his daughter-in-law Sarai,
mm-hmm.
the wife of his son Abram,
yeah.
and together they set out from Ur of the Chaldeans,
mm-hmm.
to go to Canaan.
Yeah.
But when they came to Haran, they settled there.
When they came to
Haran.
So somebody, God brought you here to become a medical doctor. But maybe out of the medical expenses, out of the educational expenses, somewhere somehow you settled for an Haran. So there are so many of us, God is telling you that the place of your calling, the place where God has destined you to be, you're operating on half. You have settled for less. The main purpose, the main goal is to make you a millionaire. But because you are an Asante man and you are 50,000, you think you are better than everybody else, you start chopping the money and you have stopped doing what will make you rich, and you are living large. But you know what? The area of your life where you think you were full, what did he do? He settled. And so many of us, we have settled for less. So the purpose of his calling was to go to where? Canaan. But on his way to Canaan, somewhere, somehow, he settled. That is why you married a wrong person. That is why you are in the wrong job. That is why you came to America. You came with a purpose to go to school.
But you came and somebody introduced you to a job with a CNA. Somebody introduced you to a woman, an old lady, they said she's rich. So they said, go and take her. You said, I'm taking care of a woman, she's rich. But remember, God brought you here to be richer than that poor woman. But because you came and you saw somebody's riches, you have settled down. But today God is coming here to prophesy upon somebody that has settled for less, that you are about to get to your promised land. You will get to your Canaan. 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 Lift up your hands and say, the Abraham's father was not supposed to settle there. The purpose of his calling was to be in Canaan. But the Bible used the word he settled. And this is one of the consequences of we black people. We have settled for less. We have settled to be slaves. We have settled to be maidservants. We have settled to be houseboys. Meanwhile, you're supposed to be the king's son. You're supposed to be the king's daughter. But because of ignorance, because of jealousy and enviness, we are not looking at the bigger goal. We have been looking at the smaller goal. Because some of you have made the little people your enemies. If little people are your enemies, once you go up a little bit, you think you are okay. But if only you can look up and see the greatness of the blessings of your God, you will not look down, but you will look up. You will not look down. But you look up, lift up and say, God, do something with my life. Say, God, do something with my life. God, do something with my life. God, do something with my life. Somebody said, I have a very good job. They pay. I said, really? You have a very good job? Huh? How much are they paying you? He said, $12 an hour. I am a supervisor at Payless. Then I said, you are too young to settle for this. You are just too young. Your father brought you here. Your father is working as a taxi driver. That's enough because, you know, he can't lift because his waist is bad. But you as a young person, what your father could not achieve whilst you are here young, I will encourage you, concentrate on education. Tomorrow by this time when your father is old, he can point his finger and say, that's my daughter, that's my son. The place where I could not get into the American education because I am old, my daughter got there, my son got there. Tell somebody, God, do something with my life. God, do something with my life. He settled. Say, I refuse to settle.
I refuse to settle.
I can't hear you. Say, I refuse to settle.
I refuse.
And some of you have settled with wrong friends. If you settle with wrong friends, they will give you wrong information. Some of you, your interest in the church, your faith in the church, your belief in God, the way you could pray some time ago, because you settled with the wrong people. When you're coming to church, something tells you, why are you even going to church? If you settle for less, you will be less. Remember, it takes two to make a quarrel. But the propensity for a fight is increased when three people are involved. You understand what I mean? When you and you are talking, we can argue like a married people. Married people, most of the time, they argue. They can argue, but bring the man's mother there, they will fight. Bring the woman's father there, they will fight. It takes two to make a quarrel, but the propensity for a fight is increased when the three people are involved. Please, if you bring the wrong person to your house, if you bring the wrong person to your business, if you bring the wrong person to your church, your interest, your blessings, you will settle for less. Say, I refuse to settle for less.
I refuse to settle for less.
Say, I refuse to settle for less.
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 Oh, I can't hear you. I refuse to settle for less. I am great.
I am great.
I have been called great.
I have been called great.
I have been blessed great.
I have been blessed great.
I am anointed great.
I am anointed great.
The purpose of my God,
the purpose of my God
is to make me great.
Is to make me great.
My children great.
My children great.
My future great.
My future great.
My destiny great.
My destiny great.
My calling great.
My calling great.
My purpose great.
My purpose great.
Say amen.
Say
amen. Say amen. Say amen. Say amen. Say amen. Say amen. Say amen. Never ever live your life and settle for less. Let me tell you something. Never allow people to choose you as friends. You should choose who should be a friend. If you allow people to choose you as friends, they will cause you to settle for less because the purpose of their life, their interests might not match yours. But because you allow them to choose you as friends and you entertain them, all too soon, the level where they are, they will put you down. But I said, I prophesy and I declare upon you, in the authority of the name of Jesus, we are not settling for less. Our God is greater. Our God is powerful. Our God is mighty. Our God is stronger. Our God is stronger. Our God is stronger. Our God is powerful. Lift up your hands and shout. Lift. He settled for less. Say, I refuse to settle for less.
I refuse to settle for less.
Say, I refuse to settle for less.
I refuse to settle for less.
The man's purpose was to get to Canaan, but he settled. And let me tell you, anybody who wants to enjoy greatness, the more greater you become, the more problems you face. So if a pastor has 10 congregations, he has 50 problems because everybody, you times them by 5. And if a pastor has 100 congregations, and when they get to 200, 300, come and ask me, I'll tell you my problems here. Anybody who wants to be great. So no, listen, never let issues and problems stop you from getting to your destiny. Never ever allow the issues of your life, the issues you come across, the pains you face in your life, never ever allow them to come and frustrate you from getting to your purpose. Lift up your hands and say, God, do something with my life.
God, do something with my life.
Now, after the man settled down, he died because he could not fulfill the purpose of God. When he died, now go to, that is Genesis 11 verse 20. You started from 26. Now, after he died, go to Genesis 12. You remember that man is the father of Abraham. All right, go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead.
The book of Genesis chapter 12, the verse number 1.
Yeah.
The Lord said to Abraham.
Now the man is there. Now God is calling his son. What did God say to Abraham?
The Lord said to Abraham, go from your country, your people, and your father's household.
Hold on. You remember they have settled somewhere. God said, my purpose is not done. That man did not fulfill his purpose on this earth. I am going to bring somebody from his own blood to continue my purpose. So his son Abraham has been called. God said, leave the place where you call your country. Leave that country. That is not the purpose of my calling. Leave that place. What happened?
Go from your country, your people, and your father's household to the land I will show you.
To a land
I will show you.
Because his father did not see the land God had given him. God is about to show him the real place of his calling. Go ahead.
Verse 2. I will make you into a great nation.
If only you will follow my calling, you will hear my purpose for your life, and you will get to the promised land. Once you get to my promised land, I will make you what?
A great nation.
And let me tell you, what do you want to be? You cannot be something you want to be, but you must be the purpose of God's calling for your life. If only you will not settle as your father settled, and you will take your time through pain, through confusion, through your disgrace, just step by step, follow the footsteps of God. Once you get to the promise of your calling, I will make you into a great nation. Go ahead.
I will make you into a great nation, and I will bless you. I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing.
I will make your name
great.
But remember, he must get to that promised land. He must be on course for God. Go ahead.
I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing.
Yeah.
I will bless those who bless you. And whoever curses you, I will curse.
Punish them one by one.
And all peoples on earth will be blessed through you.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 4. So Abraham went as the Lord had told him,
mm-hmm.
and Lot went with him.
Go ahead.
Abraham was 75 years old when he set out from Haran.
Then his father was 70 years. Even Abraham had 5 more years. But somebody must listen to God for you to get to the promised land. You can be 16 if you are disobedient to the purpose of God, you will not get to your promised land. Today, people just want Christianity like McDonald's, where they won't make stove or oven. You go through the drive-thru. Hi, man. They know every order on the line. Once they order, they go through the drive-thru, the food is ready. They pay the money without even a tip. Because, but let me tell you, Christianity is not like that. Jesus said everybody must work his own salvation. Everybody must be on course for God, and you must work your own salvation. Say amen to that.
Amen.
Go ahead, sir.
So Abraham went as the Lord had told him,
mm-hmm.
and Lot went with him.
Mm-hmm.
Abraham was 75 years old.
Go ahead.
When he set out from Haran, he took his wife, Sarai,
mm-hmm.
his nephew Lot,
mm-hmm.
all the possessions they had accumulated,
mm-hmm.
and the people they had acquired in Haran,
yeah.
and they set out for the land of Canaan.
They set out to where?
The land of Canaan.
They set out to where?
The land of Canaan. And they arrived there.
And once you arrive there, goodness and mercy shall follow you all the
days of your
life. Oh, I said, once you arrive there, goodness and mercy shall follow you
all the days of your life.
Everybody rise up. Say, I will refuse to settle for less.
I refuse to settle
for less. Oh, where are they? Say, I refuse to settle for less. I refuse to settle for less. I refuse to settle for less.
I refuse to settle for less.
Everybody lift up your hand. Lift up your hand. I'm done. I have finished preaching. So many of you have settled for less in life. But today you are about to be taken off with speed. Anything that is holding you down in the midst of your blessing, you are about to lose and set yourself free, and you will get your promised land. Lift up your two hands and close your eyes. And this is a prophecy some of you must pronounce upon your children. These are words some of you must pronounce upon your children and your household. These are things some of you must pronounce upon your children. Some of the things you know now you cannot do. You must pronounce this upon your children to become your next blessing. Why Jacob could not get, his son Joseph got there. Say, lift up your two hands and say, Lord, do something with my life.
Lord, do something with my life.
Do something new
in my life.
Something new
in my life. Something new.
Everybody begin to pray, but pray softly. Let a keyboard play. We just pray softly. Now, Lord,
What is the purpose of my calling? Lord, take me where I'm supposed to be. You belong to the mountains, but you have been flying too low. You belong to the mountains, but you have been flying too low. Come on, open your mouth and pray. That Lord, take me to where I belong. Pray that Lord, take me to where I belong. I am not going to settle for less, and I refuse to settle for less. I refuse to settle for less. I refuse to settle for less. Oh, come on, pray. That Lord, do something with my life. I am a clay in your hands. Lord, do something with me. Lord, bless me. Turn me inside out and bless me. Do something, Lord. Do something, Lord. Do something, Lord. Do something. Do something with my son. Do something with my daughter. Do something. Come on, pray, 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 pray. Pray in the name of Jesus. Lord, do something with me. Do something new. Something new.
In my life. Something new. In my life. Oh Lord. Do something new. In my life. Something new. In my life.
Lift up your two hands. Father, I thank you and I bless you for your awesome word. And Lord, the interpretation of your word. I pray that Lord, you will cause it to sink into their spirit. That Lord, we will know that Jesus, indeed, you have a purpose and a plan for our lives. For those of us that have settled for less, cause your upliftment to come into our life. That Lord, we will reach high. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Everybody sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down. Give a clap offering unto Jesus.